Hello friends, now we'll start a discussion of the quantiles and the modes, which is part of your book number 2, Quants, Random Variable Chapter, chapter number 2. And this is the last discussion of the random variables, right? So this quantiles and modes, the concept wise, it is very simple, but the way it is explained in the GARB book, it is very complicated. Okay, you will feel it very complicated. So we'll try to simplify it with the help of example, right? And for the sake of this discussion, what I try to do is we will see one code in R programming, and I will not show you how to do that coding in the R programming because it will complicate the discussion, but I will just show you the snippet, which is this is a snippet. Then we will see the result generated from that snippet, and then we will see the conclusions. Okay, we'll try to understand the conclusion, then you can read the GARB's discussion and then you will find it very easy to understand, right? So let's start the discussion first. Again, the language which is given in our notes in random variable chapter is changed completely compared to the GARB's language, because we are concerned with the learning outcomes, which is the interpretation or the final outcome of that concept, right? So we'll focus on the concept and we'll try to simplify. We are trying to simplify the language, right? So see, first, any value of x, which is the capital X is a random variable and X is the outcome, small x is the outcome, cuts the distribution of X of random variable into two parts. The part that lies in the left of the X and the part that lies in the right of the X. When the area under the density to the left of X is alpha, then the area under the density to the right is obviously 1 minus alpha, because we know the total value of the distribution, total probability in the distribution is always 1, right? And if you say the left is the alpha, the remaining portion will be 1 minus alpha. Again, we will see a diagram and all. And we call X the alpha quantile of the distribution. Okay, so again, there is a note, like this is very difficult to understand just from the language. So we will use, we'll take the help of the R programming. We will run in the R program and we will see the result and try to interpret the result, right? So let's first see what is given here. So if you take any distribution of random variable X, and if you cut this distribution in two parts at X, X is the outcome, then the left part and the right part, we will get two parts. Total is 1. If you call left part alpha, then what will be the right part? Obviously 1 minus alpha, the remaining portion, that's it, the 1 minus alpha, right? So to this alpha, we call the alpha quantile, right, for the X. Now for this example, like for the discussion purpose, we are trying to we will take the example of student score in the GARB FRM part 1 exam. So score is from 1 to 100, right? And we will try to generate some random outcomes of the score, assuming that they appeared for the exam and the result is generated. And we will take 100 of such observations, and based on that, we'll try to build the quantiles. Okay. So first, let's see just basic snippet. Okay, the code snippet. Now see here. This is a coding in R. If you know R programming, you can simply run this code. Or if you don't know, I will just explain you whatever is given here. Okay, we are not, we will not show you like actual programming here. This is not a programming class at this present. But those who have enrolled for the R programming classes, you will get to see much more than this, like how to actually pull the data, the actual data, and then build the quantiles, right? Because here I was not interested in taking actual data. I was just interested in taking some samples, drawing some random samples, right? And doing our analysis on that. So we are just taking the sample here, right? So see here. The first code is for creating a random score of students in R itself without the use of the Excel. Obviously, if you have data in your Excel, you can pull the data in R and then you can drop the data in the variable, insert that, create an array for the particular variable, and then we can run our analysis on that variable. But here we are not interested in that. We are just interested in drawing 100 random samples, the score between 1 to 100, and then see the quantiles for it. So here we are using the function which is known as the sample function. You can do much more with the sample function, but here we are just interested in some basic things. Now see, the first term here in sample, the first term is the range 100 sorry, 1 to 100. So I am telling our program that I want 1 to 100 in score. I want 100 such values. Okay, my range should be 1 to 100 because FRM students can score between 1 to 100. There is no negative marking, so there is no possibility of going values in the negative. It should be 0, but we are just assuming that there is no 0. Okay, so it should be 0 to 100, but I am taking 1 to 100. So 1 to 100, and I want 100 such observations. Right, and then I want replace T. Replace T meaning, say in the first sampling, you take 56 as a score. Then if you want to replace it, replace as in you will put it back as a 56, then there is a second chance of getting 56. So you will have in all 100 samples, in all 100 draws of samples, you will always have 56, the chance of getting 56 as a value. Instead, if you just do replace false, if you don't want to replace it, meaning what will happen? When you pull 56 out of that sample, okay, then there is no chance of 56 coming in any further observations. Okay, I hope you got the idea. So there is a basket. Again, I will give you some parallel example. Say you have basket. Okay, there are four color balls. Say color 1, color 2, color 3, color 4. Okay, you can also give side red, blue, yellow and magenta. Right. Now, if you draw the first draw and you got red. Right. Now, if I ask you in second attempt of draw, what will be the color? What should be the color? And find out the probability. Now, your question should be, are we replacing this red ball or are we not replacing this red ball? Okay. So, if you replace this red ball, then again, probability will be 1 by 4 because again, you can get the red ball in the second draw. But if you don't replace it, if you just keep it with you, then you have only remaining three colors and you will not get this red ball. Right. But in FRM exam, we know that there may be two students who can score same score, right? So 56 can be scored by 2 students, 3 students, or 10 students, right? So replacement is necessary. So we will set replace is equal to true. Okay, I hope you got the idea. So sample function, how the samples will be drawn. I want range 1 to 100 and how many numbers I want in the sample. I want total 100 such numbers and then I want to replace it. Yes, I want to replace it. This is a function. The outcome, the result of this function will be array, the series of values, series of scores, which will be stored in S score, that is student score 1. Okay, S score 1. You can give it any name. You can just say X, you can say capital X, small x. In our programming, as we know that capital X and small x are different variables, not the same variable. And it helps us in working with the random variables, of course. But here we are taking random variable is S score 1. Now, you can see two codes here. So one is the print, which will print the actual values generated from this sampling. And then just a range. These two codes are for checking purpose. So it does not play any role in your programming, right? So I wanted to verify that whatever I'm doing is correct or not. So I just took the print of SS score. So it will just show me values when I type the print. And then the range will tell me like, after final outcome, what is the range? Range is not necessarily 1 to 100. Okay. Range is likely to change because it is possible that after drawing samples, because this is sampling, after drawing samples, the lowest sample is 3, which was in this case. Okay. Which I will tell you like how. But 3 was my lowest value. So in random sampling, there was no 1 or 2. Okay. And it went up to 98. So there was even not 99 and 100. But if you run the program, if you run the same program, you will get different values because this is sampling. For every run, you will get different values. So you have to remember this. Now, working on the quantiles and percentiles of the SS score 1. Now see here, this first quantile score, if you just type quantile and if you want to take the quantile of the score, this will give you the quartile distribution of the score. Okay. So there is a particular result you will get, which I will explain you after running this quantile score, what is the result you are getting. But if you want to exactly see quantile for 20%, which is a 0.20 quantile and 0.40 quantile values, like what is the value on that particular quantile, you have to type this like the quantile, then you have to say the score 1 and I want the probabilities. Probabilities combination is 0.20, which is for 20%, and 0.40, which is 40%. If you're not able to understand it right now, don't worry, after result, I will explain you what is quantile and I will try to relate this example with the quantile concept, right? When I get the result after running this, my result is quantile score for this quantile score function, I got 0%, which is 0 quartile, 3 value, value is 3 here. Then for 25%, I got 25, just a coincidence, there is no direct relation to it. For 50%, I got 50.5. For 75%, I got 71. These are the scores and these are the quantiles. Okay. So for 70, you can say 75% quantile or you can say 0.75 quantile. So both are the same. And then we have the 100. Okay. 100% is 98. Now let's try to understand this. How the quantiles are built. So we took these samples. Now we have the sample 100 observations, 100 samples. These are not organized properly. So we will sort this sample in one particular order, say lowest to highest. And then after sorting this lowest to highest, we will see that at 0%, meaning 0% is the lowest value below which there is no values, other values. Okay. So at the 0%, 0%, the value is 3, right? Now we will take the second quantile, which is 25% or 0.25%, 0.25. The answer is 25. Now see what is the explanation or meaning of this. Meaning there are 25% observations below this 25 scores, meaning 25% of the students scored below 25 score. This is your FRM part 1 score. So 25% are below this. In our FRM result, we call it the poor quartile. Right? Now, if we take for the 50%, which is this, the value is 50.5. So this is your 50% or 0.5 quartile. In this case, this means that 50% of the students scored below 50.5. So 50% of the student score, total score is below, this is 50.5, meaning that remaining are above. That is alpha 1 minus alpha. Then we have next value, which is 75%. And on 75%, at 75%, we have value 71, I guess. Okay. This means at 71, the score 71. So 75% of the students scored below 71. Okay. Very easy to understand. And then we have the last 100% quartile. So all your observations ends at score 98. So there is no observation above 98. That's why it is 100% quantile. So 0%, 100%. And then we have the four brackets here. So first bracket is up to 25. Second bracket is up to 50. Third bracket is up to 75. And fourth bracket is up to 100. Not up to 100. That is above 75. Right. So in our GAAPS language, we call it as poor quartile, average quartile, good quartile and excellent quartile. Very simple. So this is how your result is like given in quartile forms. So this is how you can produce the quartiles. This is how we produce the quartiles of mock test. Okay. Now this is the basic understanding. Meaning, now we will try to relate this particular observation with whatever text which was given above. And then we have the second again function, which is quantile score 1 probability 0.2 and 0.40. So I wanted to check that how many percent, like what is the value, okay, at what exact score 20% students are below that. So at 22.8, that particular score, 20% students scored below 22.8 and 40% students scored below 40, right? So you are seeing similar scores here, like for 20% it's 22, because our observations are like we took like 1 to 100 outcome. We wanted sampling between the range of 1 to 100, and then we wanted only 100 values. That's why you are seeing this similarity. If you just change the range, or if you just change the total number of outcomes, okay, so this particular thing will change. For 40%, you might get some other value. Okay, now see, for 40% we have the below 40, we have 40% observations. So based on this snapshot, like this is the result. The result shows us the following observations. Lowest value in the observation is 3. The highest value in the observation is 98. Quantiles 0.25, 0.50, 0.75 cuts off at 25, 55.50, 71 and 98 respectively. Okay. Now interpreting these observations. After observing the result, we can say 25% of the observations are below 25. 25 is a score and 75% of the observations are below 71. Same you can apply for the 50% as well. You can state the same for 20% and 40%, which we got from the second function of the result. Relating these observations to the text we read above as in this text. Now we will see like how these quantiles are given. We will take the example of 0.75 quantile, which is 71. The value x is equal to 71 cuts the distribution into parts in which 75% density alpha is to the left of the x, that is 71, and the remaining 25%, which is 1 minus alpha, is in the right. We call 71.0 the 0.7 quantile. Okay, so we call 71.0 the 0.7 quantile of the distribution. So this is what you need to remember. This is what GAAP will test. Meaning P, probability of X, your random variables, total random variables will be below 71.0. Probability of your number of random variables will be 71.0 is 0.75 or 75%, right? Now this is the conclusion. So what is a quantile? Quantile is the value which cuts the distribution in particular, like for particular probability, right? So here in our case, the 0.75 quantile, that is 71, the score of 71 is 0.75 quantile, score of 25 is 0.25 quantile, like that. And you will get question on this. Okay, now see here the remaining discussion. The quantile is the inverse of CDF, meaning CDF transforms the value of cumulative probability and quantile maps the probability to specific values. Okay, there are two primary uses of quantile, which helps describe the some important features of the data set. So obviously we know, so what the quantile is doing, the CDF, so CDF transforms the value into cumulative probability, and this quantile translates the probability, because remember we are asking for this probability, like I want value for the probability of 20% and 40%. So quantile gives the value for the given probability, right? So that's why CDF and quantiles are inverse. So using these quantiles, you can derive two important parameters here, or features. This data set will give you two features. So first is the median. Median is the value at 0.5 quantile, or simply 0.5 quantile. 0.5 quantile means in our case, it is 50, I guess. Just a second. Yes, it is 50.5. Okay. So 0.5 quantile is 50.5, which is a median. What is a median? From our 10th standard discussion or the old discussions, school discussions, we know median is the mid value of any data set or any observation set, right? So this is a midpoint, and this is exactly what the median is talking about. So 0.5 quantile is means 50% are below that and 50% are above that, meaning it is a midpoint. So that's the median. Median is 0.5 quantile, value of which cuts the data point into exactly half, that is right and left is equal to equal, meaning alpha is equal to 1 minus alpha. And then interquantile range, IQR. What is the interquantile range? So the difference between 25 and 75. So total values which are in between 0.25 quantile, which is 25% quantile, and 0.75 quantile, which is 75% quantile. Here we will take the difference of 25 minus 71. Okay, so this is your IQR, interquantile range, quantile, simple. Now see what's happening here. So this becomes your Q1, this is your Q3, like this. I'm just taking a random thing. Sorry, Q25 and Q75 for 25% is 75%, not 1 and 3. Oh, sorry, 2 and 3. Okay. Now see, between this, we have some values. Okay. And these values are considered as the interquantile range. Can you relate it with the distribution? If the distribution, sorry, can you relate it with the standard deviation of the distribution? So you can relate this with the standard distribution in a way that if this interquantile range, if IQR is large, okay, if there is a difference, higher difference between the two values, the 0.25 and 0.75. So if your interquantile range is higher, meaning the standard deviation, you can relate it with the standard deviation, the deviation between the observation is higher. If this interquantile range is narrower, we will say the deviation is narrower. Again, this can be a second question of the exam, or you can relate it with your like any other discussion or with the standard deviation. So standard deviation discussion we already had, like it's very simple discussion, and this is your interquantile range discussion. Okay, so that's all about the quantile and modes. And in FRM part 2 we have quantile. I will also release a video of quantile on YouTube. Okay, there is already one video on quantile on YouTube. You can watch that, how to do it in Excel. Then we will also see how to do it in R, right, in your R programming classes. Okay, so that's all about the quantile discussion. Thank you for watching.